Welcome to Naresh AI Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In this video, I'm going to discussing about one more special object in java.io package, that is byte array output stream, java.io.byte array output stream. What is the speciality of this class? What is the advantage of this class? Very simple. With the help of file output stream, I can able to write the data into the file at a time, only single file at a time. With the help of the data output stream, we can able to write the data into again single file at a time. If you are using object output stream, again we can able to write the data into single file at a time. But I want to write the same data into multiple files at a time, then we should prefer the concept like what? Byte array output stream. What is the use of byte array output stream? It is useful for sending the same data from java application to multiple files at a time. For that purpose we are using byte array output stream. So what type of constructor do we have related to byte array output stream? java.io.byte array output stream. Now if you carefully observe, we have two constructors. Now let me develop a program on what byte array output stream with zero argument. It's a damn easy thing. And one more thing is, observe here, we need to concentrate on what? Write to method. Here we need to, whatever the program I'm going to discussing about in this video, I'm using this constructor as well as I'm using this method. Now observe. And one more important point is byte array output stream is not directly communicating with the file. Byte array output stream is taking the support of what? Output stream objects. Nothing but, especially in this program, I'm using support of what here? File output stream. So byte array output stream providing the facility to sending the same data into multiple files at a time, but it is not directly, it will not doing, it will take the support of what here? Again, file output stream class objects. Now let me develop one program on top of byte array output stream. Right clicking on src class byte array output stream demo. Very simple. Now let me take main method here, main here. So here I'm writing like file output stream fos equal to new file output stream. I'm taking one file like test1.txt. This is what here, fos1. Later, I'm creating one more object, file output stream fos2 equal to new file output stream test2.txt. So these constructors are throwing one exception. Already we know that. What is that? File not found exception. Good. Now, so here I'm taking what your string. We guys know that file output stream having lot of constructors like file output stream with a file parameter, file output stream with a file with a boolean, and a string with a boolean, file descriptor, like this lot of constructors we have. Here I'm using the concept like what here? Only file output stream with a string. Later, file output stream, I'm taking one more class like fos3 equal to new file output stream. Here I'm writing like test3.txt. Now after that, what I'm writing here, I'm taking the support of. Now my intention is I want to place the data, same data into multiple files at a time. Then we need to take the support of what here, byte array output stream. Byte array output stream. BOS equal to new byte array output stream. Here I'm taking the support of. Here I'm taking the support of what here? A zero argument. Byte array output stream itself not communicating with the file for writing the data. Byte array output stream will taking the support of file output stream. How, sir? So I want to write some data. How? BOS dot write to method. BOS dot write to method. And in this write to method, I'm writing like FOS1. Now, write to method will throwing one exception. What is that IO exception? So file not found exception is replaced with IO exception. Once we throwing the IO exception, automatically all its subclasses are going to throw. Now, how many files I'm going to send the data at a time? I want to send the data to more than one file, FOS1, FOS2. Later, what is this? BOS dot write to, what is this? FOS3. So like this I have what here? Three methods, like write to, three methods. And first to write to method is trying to communicating with the FOS1, and FOS1 is communicating with the test1, and whatever the data which we are going to write under the BOS, that data will go and place into area test1.txt. Up to now, I'm creating three objects, those three file output stream objects. Those three file output stream objects will communicating with what here? Same byte array output stream object. Now I want to send the data. How can I send the data? Which data I'm going to send the data? BOS dot write. BOS dot write. What I'm writing like a new byte array. New byte array. I'm writing like 100, 100 as well as what here? 97, 100 and 32. 32, and I'm writing some other data like BOS dot write to like new byte of array. Here I'm writing like 109 111 109 109 111 109. So this is the data I want to place into varier file itself. So how we are going to place the data? We are taking the support of what here? FOS1 and FOS2, FOS3, nothing but byte array output stream is taking the support of what here? File output stream, and file output streams are communicating with the files for sending the data. Now, system.out.println, here I'm writing like process completed. System.out.println, process completed. Let me right clicking on this file and click on run as, and click on what here? Java application. Now, process completed. Process completed means our program is successfully executed. Let me refresh our project. If you refresh our project, we have three text files here creating in our Java project. One is test1.txt, another one is test2.txt, another one test3.txt. If you cleanly observe, here I have test3. Test3 data is what here? Dot and mom. Test2 data is also what here? Dot and mom. And test1, in the test1 is also what here? Dot and mom. So what is meaning here? The same data will go and place it into where here? Multiple files at a time. The same data go and place it into where here? Multiple files at a time. How? With the help of a byte array output stream. So whatever the program I written up to now, let me show you diagrammatic representation related to this program. Now, initially, how many file output stream objects we created? Three file output stream objects we created. Three file output stream object. Good. Now, what are the names for these file output stream objects here? One is FOS1, another one is FOS2, another one is FOS3. There are three file output stream objects. Now, one special object I created. What is that special object? Byte array output stream object. This is nothing but what here? BOS object. In the BOS object, I'm writing like what here? 100, 97, 100, 32. 100, 97, 100, 32. Nothing but 100 will be replaced with what here? D. And 97 will be replaced with A. And again 100 will be replaced with D. And 32 replaced with what here? Space. And after that, now M109 will be replaced with M. 111 will be replaced with O. And again 109 will be replaced with what here? Mom. Dot space and mom. So this data will go and place it into where here? This data, initially we are writing like 100, next one 97, next one 100, and next one 32, next one 32. Later, I'm writing some other data. What is that? 109, 111, 109. So like this, I'm placing the data into where here? BOS. Now BOS is communicating with what? BOS is communicating with FOS1. BOS is communicating with FOS1. And this BOS is communicating with FOS2. And this BOS is communicating with FOS3. How? With the support of one method. What is that method? Write2 method. Write2 of FOS1, write2 of FOS2, and write2 of FOS3. So, whatever the data which we have in the BOS, that data will come and place into where here FOS1 and FOS2 and FOS3. These FOS1 and FOS2 and FOS3 are communicating with what here? Multiple files, different files. These are the files. What are these file names? Already, I designed in the program. What is that? Test1.txt as well as test2.txt as well as test3.txt. So, FOS1 will communicating with what here? FOS1 will communicating with test1. FOS1 will communicating with the test1. Good. Next one is FOS2 communicating with the test2. And FOS3 communicating with what here? Test3. Now, the data is traveled from where? The data is traveled from BOS2. Data is traveled from BOS2, FOS1. From FOS2, what is this? Test1.java. In the same manner, data is traveled from BOS2, FOS2, and after that, control going to where here? Test2.java. And after that, again, BOS object to, what is that? FOS3 object. From FOS3 object to, control going to where here? Test3 object. Now, once the data is coming to file, the data will be placed like this. Dad space mom. Dad space mom. Control C. Control V. Control V. Yes. Object here. So whatever the data we are placed into where here byte array output stream, that data finally coming to what here? Test1 and test2 and test3. Whatever the data which we have in the BOS, the data first coming to FOS1. FIS2, FIS3, and from the data coming to what here? Test1 and Test2, Test3 files. So now, by seeing this diagram, you came to one conclusion. With the help of byte array output stream, the same data we can able to send into the multiple files at a time. That is the greatness of byte array output stream. I hope you enjoy this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.